the real frightening thing. As you look at what is happening, if you, one of the things we do as futurists do is look at, you know, like basically metabolic rates of stuff, is technology is spooky. All right, you all are probably familiar with Moore's Law, which means that computational power basically doubles every 18 months. Storage space, storage capacity doubles every 12 months. Communications bandwidth, you know, basically that doubles every 9 months. So with colleagues we studied the world your future colleagues with, what that means is, if you're good with fractions and linearities, what that means is we are 15 years away from when every molecule on this planet is IP addressable. We are moving from E, which is e-commerce and basically search and information, to B, which is virtual. Alright? There is adventure travel money to be made in virtual worlds. Alright, so that's something to think about and play in and be aware of. Right? Again, more homework. Good, this is working.
Wireless phones?
Okay.
Phones?
I said the computer.
So let's have some answers. Let's, you know, right over there. You know, yes, ma'am.
Hi, I'm Teresa Storm. I'm a Canadian travel journalist, eh? And our icon is a slave with a ball and chain around the ankle, and attached to the end of the ball and chain is a laptop, a cell phone, a pager, and in the ear.
Very good.
Hi. We don't pretend to be artists or anything, but we just did the Macintosh logo. Okay. Oh, nice. My name is Paula, and I'm a BCIT marketing tourism student. And what I think is huge in our icon is a computer chip, because it's in everything.
All right. These are not necessarily positive images, but you know, we've done this around the country, around the world, and a couple of people have come up with some interesting visuals. Here's one. I've got for our age, you know. I mean, like, you know, police, you know. I mean, so I'm listening to my own little world, you know. Here's what goes on. How many hours are there in the day? That's another question. Everybody says 24. Well, really, thanks to technology, it's 43. I mean, if you add up all the multitasking type of stuff, I mean, hello. We've got it. This is bad, right? You just look at all these hours. I mean, it's getting crazy. And sleep. This woman is dating. Does she look happy? We can help her. We can help her. I mean, we talked about affinity. By the Jared and by the way, one of the best pieces of future, you know, was basically the global trans talk that our two colleagues did yesterday. So do get that slide deck. Absolutely brilliant. But I mean, this is what we humans have become like. It's just spooky. Just spooky. And then, here we go. Choose your accelerant. Choose your accelerant. So that's going to, and you can get all those people move, I'm going to change your job. The average 34-year-old has changed jobs 9 times. 600 million hours a week, people are alone in their cars. Yesterday, in that wonderful global press, we said, like, people are afraid to go outside. We've got to fix that. Right? We really got to fix that. And here's where it comes, and I know I'm just about out of time, and I will return the podium to adult supervision, but nature as a form of therapy. All right? Doctors wrote 190 prescriptions for antidepressants in 2006. They're using it as candy. Here's a big insight, which you all know about. This is why you look the way you do, and I look the way I do, all right? It's an alternative treatment for mild depression that is cheaper because of spending time engaged in vigorous activity in the outdoors. Well, duh!